Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. And say, today I want to say a special hello to all the moms out there because, as you know, today is Mother's Day. And I trust that you will be treated not just today, but every day as the special woman that you are. We are going to begin our program today with a hymn that is a favorite of many. Words are by Martin Janus. The year was 1661, and the music was by none other than Johann Sebastian Bach. Jesu, joy of man's desiring. Enjoy. Now is George Beverly Shea with The King Is Coming.
The marketplace is empty, no more traffic in the streets. All the builders' tools are silent, no more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labors in the courtroom. No debate. Work on earth is all suspended as the king comes through the gate.
Happy faces line the hallways, those whose lives have been redeemed, broken homes that he has mended, those from prison he has freed. little children and the aged, hand in hand, stand all aglow, who were crippled, broken, ruined, now dressed in garments white as snow. I can hear the chariots rumble, I can see the marching throng, the flurry of God's trumpets spell the end of sin and wrong. Regal robes are now unfolding, heaven's grandstands all in place, heaven's choir is now assembled, start to sing amazing.
Continue with another selection by George Beverly Shea, and it's called I Shall Not Be Moved. Hey, when our feet are planted firmly in God's Word, that's it. We shall not be moved.
Glory, hallelujah, I shall not be moved. Anchored in Jehovah, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved.
I shall not be moved.
In His love abiding, I shall not be moved. And in Him confiding, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved.
Though the tempest rages, I shall not be moved. On the rock of ages, I shall not be moved.
Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved.
Henry Williams Baker, 1821 to 1877, authored the words of the hymn, "The King of Love My Shepherd Is." And it was reported that by one of his close friends, who sat by his bedside as Baker lay dying, that Henry repeated the words of one verse from his hymn. And those words were, "Perverse and foolish oft I strayed, but yet in love he sought me, and on his shoulder gently laid, and home rejoicing brought me. The King of Love my shepherd is." William Ralph Featherstone was born in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, in the year 1846. He died as a young man in 1873, and he's buried in Mount Royal Cemetery in Montreal. At the tender age of 16, Featherstone composed the words to the hymn, "My Jesus, I Love Thee."
Savior,
In the book of Isaiah, chapter 64, verse 8, we read, "We are the clay, you are the potter, we are all the work of your hand." Adelaide A. Pollard, in the year 1907, was inspired by those words from the prophet Isaiah, and from that he composed the hymn, "Have Thine Own Way, Lord." I'm always impressed about the story of the author of our next hymn. Every time I read it, his name was Martin Rinkhart. Now, Rinkhart was a Lutheran pastor, and he lived in Saxony during the 30 Years' War. The walled city where he lived saw a steady stream of refugees pour through its gates. The Swedish army surrounded the city, and famine and plague were running rampant. 800 homes were destroyed, and the people began to perish. There was a tremendous strain on the pastors, who had to conduct dozens of funerals daily. Finally, the pastors too succumbed, and Rinkhart was the only one left, doing 50 funerals a day. When the Swedes demanded a huge ransom, Rinkhart left the safety of the walls to plead for mercy. The Swedish commander, impressed by his faith and courage, lowered his demands. Soon after the 30 Years' War ended, and Rinkhart wrote this hymn for a grand celebration service. It is indeed a testament to his faith that after such misery, he was able to write a hymn of abiding trust and gratitude toward God.
Jesus.
Christian H. Bateman, in the year 1843, composed the words to the hymn, Come Christians, Join to Sing, perhaps based on Psalm 95, verse 1. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord.
Come, Christians, join to sing. Alleluia, amen. Love, grace to Christ our King. Alleluia, amen. Let all with heart and voice before His throne rejoice. Praise is His gracious choice. Alleluia.
Of our next hymn were written by German Jesuits in the 17th century. They were translated from German to English by Joseph A. Sees in 1873. I hope that you enjoy the hymn, Fairest Lord Jesus.
Fairest Lord Jesus, the earth.
I trust that you enjoyed our selection of hymns today, folks, and I hope that the good Lord willing that you'll join us next week as well for yet more of great hymns of the faith. God bless.